Hello everyone, welcome to Success Education. Today we'll be doing the workbook solution for environmental studies for standard 5, chapter number 5, that is seed. Before that, if you have not subscribed my channel till now, please do subscribe it for more videos. So we'll be starting with the MCQs. First one, which of the following plants is known as a hunter plant? It's option number D, pitcher plant. Second, seeds of which plant are spread by wind? It's option number A, milkweed. Third, seeds of which plant are spread by water? It's option number C, coconut. Fourth, which of the following seeds is bigger than a pea? It's option number B, rajma, that is kidney bean. Fifth, which of the following seeds has a rough texture? It's option number D, gram. Sixth, seeds of which plant have minute thorns? It's option number A, cocklebur. Seventh, which fruit has a large seed? It's option number B, chiku. Eighth, from where did chilies come to India? It's option number C, South America. Now we'll continue with question number 2, that is fill in the blanks. First one, the doctor advises a sick person to eat sprouted lentils. Second, a shoot sprouts out from a seed and then grows into a plant. Third, out of a milkweed, alfalfa grass and cocklebur, the seeds of alfalfa spread through water. Fourth, out of green gram, flat beans and maize is a food grain. Fifth, seeds of cocklebur are spread by animals. Sixth, out of seeds of gram, okra, that is lady's finger, and cotton, the seeds of okra are smooth. Seventh, out of flat bean, mustard, and bitter gourd, the seeds of bitter gourd are rough. Eighth, coconut seeds are spread through water. Now we'll continue with question number 3, that is true or false. First one, a sick person is advised to eat sprouted wheat. It is false. Second, to sprout lentils, they are first soaked in water. It is true. Third, only air is necessary for a seed to grow. It is false. Fourth, when a flat bean sprouts, two separate cotyledons are seen. It is true. Fifth, if spoiled seeds are sown, they do not sprout or grow. It is true. Sixth, all seeds have the same shape. It is false. Seventh, fruits of plants have seeds. It is true. Eighth, coconut seeds are spread by wind. It is false. Now we'll continue with question number 4, that is match the following. First one, cocklebur seeds, it's option number D, means the fourth one, animals. Second, sweet basil, that is takmaria seeds, it's option number E, means the fifth one, water. Third, milkweed seeds, it's option number B, means the second one, wind. Fourth one, banyan seeds, it's option number A, means the first one, birds. Now we'll continue with question number 5, that is answer the following questions in one or two sentences. First one, which factors are needed for a seed to grow? Air, water and heat are needed for a seed to grow. Second, how are seeds of the cocklebur and the greater burdock plants dispersed or spread? Seeds of the plants like the cocklebur and the greater burdock are dispersed by animals. Third, which factors play a role in the dispersal of seeds? Factors that play a role in the dispersal of seeds are first, wind, second, water, third, insect, and fourth, birds and animals. Fourth one, give 4 examples of food grains. So wheat, bajra, rice and maize are examples of food grains. Fifth, whose seeds are spread by wind? Seeds of milkweed, Indian beech and cotton tree are spread by wind. Sixth, how are seeds of sweet basil, that is takmaria, spread? Seeds of sweet basil, that is takmaria, are spread by water. Seventh, how many types of seeds are there? Which are they? There are 2 types of seeds, They are monocotyledons and dicotyledons. 8. What does dicotyledon seed mean? Seeds which can be broken into two parts are known as dicotyledons, that is, dicots. 9th one, which plants can be grown without seeds? So, potato, rose, banana, guava, etc. grow without seeds. 10th, what would happen if the plants do not get water? They would dry up or turn yellow. 11th, what is inside the seed? Inside the seeds, there are cotyledons and embryo. 12th, how does a big plant grow from a tiny seed? The seedling absorbs water and nutrients from the ground and grows into a big plant. 13th, name a few games that can be played with seeds. So, kuka or panchika, like the one played with fever nuts, can be played with tamarind seeds. Now we'll continue with question number 6, that is, answer the following questions. First one, how are lentils sprouted? Lentils are sprouted in water overnight. In the morning, the water is drained off and the seeds are tied up in a wet cloth and hung on a nail or hook. Then after a day or two, the lentils sprout. Second one, how are seeds spread by wind? Explain with an example. Seeds of many plants are very light and have thin thread-like structures. Such seeds are carried by swift winds and spread far and wide. Thus, wind helps in dispersal of seeds. For example, seeds of milkweed, that is akro, Indian beech, that is kanji, and cotton tree, that is shimlo. Third one, why do plants grow in all places during monsoon, that is rainy season? Seeds are spread due to various factors. Due to this, various types of seeds are lying on the ground at many places. When it rains during the monsoons, these seeds get enough water to sprout and starts growing. This is why plants grow in all places during monsoon. Fourth one, after sowing seeds, if the soil becomes waterlogged, that is too much water, then why does the seed not sprout? It is necessary for seeds to get sufficient water in order to sprout. Along with water, it is equally necessary that the seeds get air and sunlight. If the soil becomes waterlogged after seeds are sown, then the seeds get neither air nor heat. As a result, the seeds do not sprout if the soil in which they are sown is waterlogged. Fifth one, whole tuer can sprout but tuer dal cannot. Why so? It is because after splitting, the sprouting capacity of tuer is lost. Sixth one, what would happen if seeds did not spread and remained at one place only? If the seeds did not spread out, they would fall in the parent bed itself, leading into struggle for water, minerals and sunlight. As a result, none of the plants would grow properly or survive. Seventh one, explain with examples any two factors that play a role in dispersal of seeds. So first one is by wind. Seeds that are light in weight are carried by wind from one place to another and get dispersed. For example, seeds of milkweed, that is akro, Indian beech, that is kanji, and cotton tree, that is shimlo, drumstick, that is saragwo, etc. Second factor is by water. Seeds that are light and can float on water are pulled along by streams, rivers, etc. and are taken to far off places. For example, coconuts, lotus, alfalfa grass seed, that is rajko, sweet basil, that is takmaria, etc. Now, 8th question. State the advantages of seed dispersal, that is spreading of seeds. When seeds of a vegetation spread far and wide, the area around that vegetation is not clogged with the same type of plants. Plants grow in different places due to seed dispersal. So the competition to gain sufficient amounts of water, nutrients from soil and sunlight reduces and they grow well. One type of vegetation gets a chance to spread and grow in various places due to seed dispersal. Thus, the area of the particular vegetation type increases. Now we'll continue with question number 7, that is answer as asked. First one, write the names of the seeds of the trees given below. So first one, neem. The name of the seed is neem seed. Second one, tamarind. So name of the seed is tamarind seed. Third one, jujube. It's jujube seed. Fourth one, mango. It is mango seed. And fifth one, banyan. It is banyan seed. Second question, state the color and the texture of the following seeds. So first one, green gram. It is of green color with smooth texture. Second one, gram. It is of brown color with rough texture. Third one, pea. It is of light green color with smooth texture. Fourth one, mango seed. It is whitish in color with rough texture. Fifth one, maize. It is in yellow color with smooth texture. Sixth one, wheat. It is in light brown color with smooth texture. Seventh one, watermelon seed. It is of black color with smooth texture. Eighth one, neem seed. It is of yellowish green color with rough texture. Now the third question, write two names of each. First one, seeds that are used as spices in the kitchen. It is cumin and mustard. Second, seeds of vegetables. It is tomato and bitter gourd. Third, seeds of fruit. It is apple and mango. Fourth, light seeds that is checked by blowing on them. It is cumin and mustard. Fifth one, flat seeds. It is sesame and watermelon. Now we'll continue with question number 8, that is classify as required. First classification is between food grains, lentils and oil seeds. So food grains are bajra, maize, wheat, jowar and bunti. Lentils are green gram, gram, flat beans and mat. Oil seeds are sesame, castor seed and mustard. The second classification is seeds spread by water, wind or by animals and birds. So seeds spread by water are coconut, alfalfa grass seeds and sweet basil. Seeds spread by wind are milkweed, cotton tree, Indian beech and jivanti, that is dodi. And seeds spread by animals and birds are guava, cocklebur, great burdock, prickly chaff flower and banyan tree. The third classification is between smooth seeds and rough seeds. So smooth seeds are green gram, pea, rajma, maize, wheat, mustard, lady's finger and watermelon. And rough seeds are gram, cumin, aniseeds, bitter gourd, cotton, neem, mango and papaya. Now we'll continue with the HOTS questions, that is MCQs. First one, which is the smallest of the following seeds? It's option number C, mustard. Second, which seeds are spread by animals? It's option number D, prickly chaff flower. Third, which seeds are not spread by water? It's option number B, cocklebur. And fourth, which type of soil is considered favorable for seeds to grow? It's option number C, soft soil. And here we come to the end of chapter number 5, that is seed. I hope you have understood the complete chapter. If you have any doubts, you can write in the comments section. I'll surely try to answer all the questions. Thank you for watching my video and do subscribe my channel for more updates. Thank you.